What's up, folks? It's Steve Holmes here, making a video about making a video about making a video. That's what we're doing right now. You're looking at Adobe Premiere Pro. This is my video editing software of choice these days. I'm editing a footage from a live performance of my band recently. We did an 8-camera shoot at our gig, and I'm editing together the footage, and some people ask me about the editing process and that kind of thing, and so I thought I would try to make a video while I'm editing this next tune. The window's kind of cramped. I had to shrink things down to get it to fit into this desktop capture thing, and playback is a bit choppy, and then eating as well, so those are my caveats. We'll do the best we can with this, okay? Should be fun. This tune is called Digging Out. It's a kind of a jazzy tune. Just so you know, the cameras that we're dealing with, the top camera is a GoPro cam. That's a GoPro camera that's on my chest. I'm the drummer in the band. The next camera is a close-up of the bass player. His name is John Flitcraft. The next is a kind of handheld side view of me. The next camera is handheld close-up front shot of Jeff, the guitar player. All these shots are like just the waist, apparently. The next camera that we have to choose from is a group shot, like a wide shot from a mounted camera. After that, it's another overhead shot of me on drums, and after that we have a static cam of John, the bass player, and then after that a static cam of Jeff. It's kind of a wide shot that also has the audience here, which I like to show when there's audience reaction. Excuse me. So I'm about a minute into editing. Do is play you what I have, and then just continue editing, basically. All right. So the start of this tune revolves around a bass line. Basically, they just kind of the bass line is the theme of the song, and it's kind of a pseudo jazzy bass line. And so I'm just kind of playing kind of simple jazz time behind it. So I'll play you what I have. Hopefully, the playback won't be too choppy. It should be smooth at first, but then it's going to get choppy. That's as much editing as I've done. You can see the video starts to get choppy like about halfway through that. I've messed with the settings and stuff for the video capture, the desktop capture stuff, and this is the best that I could do. So this is the best lemonade I can make with these lemons, unfortunately. Hopefully it's not too annoying to watch. So because of the moodiness of the beginning, I decided to start using like dissolves. I kind of like this moody thing that Jeff does. I mean, I wanted to start with the bass player because he's the guy that starts the tune. Usually I'll start with like a wide shot of the band, but for this one I thought it would be okay. I kind of like dissolving to Jeff here because he's about to play something tasty, and that ended up going into this section where it's like, you know, just quickly dissolve. By the time we dissolve to one shot, I'm just quickly dissolving in the next one. So there's Jeff, and I kind of like the little side cymbal thing I do there. And then I went to the establishing wide shot. I like the waitress silhouette right there. It doesn't get in the way, and it just kind of makes it feel like a kind of cool like jazz club kind of thing. So there's Jeff playing some tasty stuff. That's me hitting the cymbal on my left, and I kind of dissolve to the side view of me hitting it right as I'm about to hit it, and then it goes to Jeff. Um, Play, please. Alright, well that thing that Jeff just did, I'd kind of like to show that. It definitely helps to be intimately familiar with the music while you're editing. Because that just kind of tells you like what to show and when to show it, you know? Being the drummer in the band definitely helps when you're doing this kind of stuff. I'm not like a Premiere Pro master. So for those of you that are watching this that are really good, I apologize ahead of time for not doing things in the most quick and efficient way. I mean, some of you might be, you know, angrily watching and being like, no, you need to right-click and ripple delete or something, you know, like watching your grandfather surf the web and, like, slowly type in URL messages, URL addresses. Anyway, let's get to that part where Jeff was playing the thing. I want to show that right here. So he kind of plays it right there. All right, and from there, I don't know, how's that wide shot of John? I keep using the close-up. So this track right here, that's the wide shot of John. So I'm going to try to use that as the next thing to show. Let's switch these over. Get rid of this guy. So we added the thing with Jeff right here. Oh, I forgot to cut the overhead drum track, sorry. So I'll move that out of the way. All right. So as you can see, for those that aren't familiar with how this program works, basically it plays all the tracks at the same time, starting at the top. So if the top track is in there, it'll play the second one. If the second track is in there, you play the third one, etc., all the way down. So based on that, you just cut away layers, and it'll play whatever's on top. You just have to dictate on top. I kind of like the fact that John is smiling there. He doesn't emote too much in this footage, so. Alright, so that cymbal swelled him. That thing right there. I'll probably cut to me or Jeff at that point, but I want to stay on John because he's smiling. So I'm going to dissolve out of Jeff and go to John right there. Alright, since we're doing wide shot, since we're on a wide shot of John, let's see what the wide shot of Jeff looks like. And cut to that while he's playing that cool little thing right there. Yeah, he's stomping on pedals, which might look cooler from the close-up. Let's see what that looks like. Now you can't really see his legs. Yeah, I kind of like this angle better, actually. But there's that cymbal swell thing. I might be able to squeeze in a shot of the drums playing that really quick. So let's bring over the overhead track, the overhead view that we get. So there's I kind of like the left hand on the cymbal thing right there. I'm always a fan of the left hand, like on camera. I just think traditional grip kind of looks cool, you know. So what were we doing? We were staying on John until the cymbal swell, right? Right there, there's the cymbal swell, so we'll start to fade in, start to dissolve right there on the cymbal swell, because I kind of like that. And then Jeff comes in soon after with that little da-da-da. Well, now it's chugging on playback, so it's hard to get. I can hear Jeff right there playing that thing I want to show. So let's try to dissolve into that. Maybe a little earlier. Maybe a little earlier if I can zoom in. Yes, thank you. We'll shorten this. We'll bring this up to there. Yeah, that'll work. All right, let's play it. Let's play it from here. Well, like I said, it's chugging on playback, but I can tell that that timing is going to work. We can actually render it really quick. I don't know if that's a good idea because it uses a lot of the computer processor. And while we're doing this video, that might not be a good idea. Let's start from here and render. See how long that takes. Like a minute. So basically what happens musically, that's what tells me what to show. And basically from there, it's a question of do I want to show the group? Is it like a group statement with all of us playing together? Or is it like something that showcases the person? And then from there, it's like, well, what camera looks cooler, basically. And I've been kind of getting into the picture-in-picture stuff to kind of show several angles at once, which I'll probably end up doing at some point in here. So that's kind of fun. But I just like to try to tell the story visually that the music is telling. And keep in mind the things that interest me as a viewer, you know, having seen tons and tons of concert videos and knowing, you know, if you're a musician, you might know like what it's like to watch a video and be like, oh, why are they not showing the important thing to show? Well, that works. I mean, there was a second where I don't know what the hell that is. What the hell is that? Media pending. Media is not pending. Media is right there. Why is it interesting? Is there like a little section of unrendered media or something? Maybe I mean, scooch this and get rid of it. Yeah, I got rid of it, but now that section isn't rendered. Eh, whatever. Come on, you can do it. Play. Yeah. So we've shown several close-ups, and so I'd like to go back to a group shot at this point, just to kind of once again establish like who's playing, like what are we watching kind of thing, you know? So let me kind of trim away. This is the group shot camera right here, and the question now is when do we want to cut to it? Right there. Usually I'll take a musical downbeat, which if you're not a musician, a downbeat is just the pulse that you find yourself tapping your foot to when the music is playing. And so, you know, it's pretty common to time the edits of a music piece to the pulse of the tune. So that's what I'm doing there. Scooch these over because I still want to stay on the wide shot. before Jeff's going to come in with the main melody of the tune shortly. And so that's going to be more close-ups. So the question is, how long do we stay on the wide shot? Let's watch. All right, Jeff's about to play the melody right there, and I do another little cymbal swish. So let's show the cymbal swish, and then we'll cut to Jeff. We haven't used the side camera. I can tell where I'm doing the cymbal swish right there. See my hands on the cymbals. What does that look like with the side cam? Yeah. That adds motion to the shot, so we'll cut to this. Actually, this will be kind of cool. Yeah, right there. But before that, I do like a little floor tom thing. Yeah. All right, let's dissolve into that. So I'm gonna add a dissolve transition that basically fades it in like that. And then right from there, we'll fade into Jeff, who's about to play the melody. And that shot will work. So let's cut the drum cam, scooch it over, and how's this transition going to work from me doing the cymbal swell to Jeff playing the melody? Maybe hit a wrong note. I'm not sure. I'm wondering now if I should show the wide shot of Jeff first and then go to the close-up. I think I'll do that. Getting the wide shot of Jeff is always a pain in the ass because it's like it's the eighth layer, so you gotta cut everything and scooch it all over. And I'm also gonna dissolve from the cymbal swell. So we need this. Do we? Yeah, we do. You can get out of here. Where's the wide? Okay, this is the wide shot of Jeff right here. So let's dissolve to that instead of the close shot. Now, as you can see here, it's like the cymbal swell shot that we chose earlier. It's hardly present at all. See? It dissolves in, it dissolves out as soon as it starts, which kind of visually matches a cymbal swell. It's like, so I kind of like that. Let's see what that looks like. Yes. Yes. That'll work. Let's keep that. Let's keep that. Now the question is, when do we switch to the close-up of Jeff? Right there. There's space there. And he's doing the little whammy bar thing. So switching cameras in the middle of doing something and getting that kind of seamless transition I like. Is this the Jeff cam? It is. Okay, so let's put it there. We can see his hands on the whammy bar. Yeah. So there's some space between those phrases, and so I think that's a good place to switch cameras. Now it's just more of the bass line. Let's see what John's doing here. Maybe we can cut to him. No, we've got waitresses walking in front of the camera. What does the Y John cam look like? That shot I like. The lighting is cool there. The way he's bobbing his head is kind of cool. Let's use that. Question is, once again, when do we cut to it? Okay, that little thing I did on the drums right there. Let's show that from the side or from the top, because the last time we showed me was from the side. So let's use the top camera to show those little cymbal thingies. And then we'll go to the shot of John. Let's try that. Here's the overhead. Let's cut the Jeff shot. All right, so that's about as much as I want to show of that. And we're going to overlap this a little bit so we can dissolve it. This tune stops being an ambient tune and gets more like down to business. And at that point, we'll stop doing the dissolve transitions, and we'll do like more hard cuts, like just directly cutting from camera to camera. All right, so right there, we'll dissolve to John after I'm done my little cymbal stuff. Let's scooch all of these over. I'm a total amateur at this, in terms of like how to use this program and whatever. So once again, if you're a Premiere Pro guru, I apologize for not doing things like the most efficient way. All right, yeah, we get that head bob there from John that I liked. Let's watch that transition. All right, we did the cymbal swell. We did the wide shot of Jeff, and that led to a close-up shot of Jeff. Sorry, the Premiere Pro is not... It's not playing what's on the screen. Come on, Premiere Pro, you can do it. What happens if we play? What happens if we push the play button? There we go. There's the wide shot. Cut to the close shot. Yes, there's a cymbal swell. Okay, so Jeff comes in again right there. So let's go back to the close-up for that. Whoops, sorry. Close-up Jeff cam, here we go, right when he comes in. Okay, so the waitress walks by. Sometimes that can work, actually, like in the beginning, right, in the wide shot. We saw the waitress. When she, like, walks right by the camera, that can be a pain in the ass, but when she's in the background, it kind of works. Or sometimes I'll kind of use her walking in front as, like, a handshake, like, from camera to camera. Like, she'll walk by one camera, and I'll cut to the other camera, and she'll walk by again. Sometimes that works. Let's try that. Does she walk by the John cam ever, I wonder? John is the bass player. No, I don't see her at all. I kind of like that he's looking over at Jeff there, but I don't think we're going to use that. All right, Jeff's about to come in right there. Ooh, I'm adjusting the volume on the Jeff track. That's not my intention. All right, Control Z to undo that. All right. Oh, see that when that camera comes in, it's like shaky at the beginning right there. See that? See that shake? I don't like that. Well, let's just come in later. Maybe we'll go back to the wide shot, which is under here. Sorry, I'm mumbling. All right, scooch this over, and this is the wide shot right here. So that actually might work. Yeah, that'll work. Yeah, that'll work. So let's dissolve into that. We'll make a short dissolve. All right, right there, he's about to play another phrase. So let's go to the close-up on that. How we doing, close-up cam? Do you have usable footage? I kind of like when I'm playing there. I do this thing on the drums where I'm like, it's kind of the drum language version of that. Let's see what that looks like from the side. Oh, this guy's got the camera guy. He's got me really close here. I don't know if it's going to work. No, I don't like that. Except at the end when I hit the cymbals, like right there. I kind of like that. But let's assume we won't use that. Although we have not used the GoPro cam yet. This thing. Haven't used it yet in this song. So maybe this will be... Maybe this will be the start of it. Excuse me. Yeah, that might work, because we do those two hits at the end, da, 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 whenever you get it. You get what I'm saying. All right, let's get this guy. You guys get out of here, we're showing this. I don't know. What's the top down cam look like? Let's try that for that little drum phrase that we're showing. Let's try the top down cam. You go away. You. Let's just disable you. And let's play. That might work. I think I like that better, actually. So, let's delete this guy. Although that left hand on the cymbal right here. I remember liking how that looked on the side cam. Because we get the motion here, so... What does that look like? I don't know if I like that. Actually, I got it. The wide shot of me establishes that we're seeing the drummer. Then we'll go to the GoPro camera so it's not so jolting, right? That's the thing about the GoPro is it's like first person and it can be a little jarring, but I find that when you cut to the GoPro after showing a wide shot of the drummer, and then you get this tighter shot of the GoPro, then it kind of connects it better. Yeah, right there. I think that's good. I'm going to leave that, and then from there we're going to show more Jeff, because Jeff's playing the melody. So let's go to Jeff. You get out of here, tracks. You move over, Jeff track, please, because it's time to show you. Yes. He's making a cool musician face there, too, so we got lucky. Do we want to dissolve from the GoPro to the Jeff cam? I think maybe not, actually. Sorry that I'm eating. Alright, we showed me, we showed Jeff, we showed a wide shot. It's time to show John. Oh, he's smiling! It's perfect. Perfect time to show John. Sorry, it's choppy. See, it's just him smiling, though. Like, it would be nice. See, that's the thing is, I get frustrated with the cameraman sometimes, because I'm like... I mean, I don't know. Sometimes I think the tightest you should ever get is like from the waist to the face. All right, what am I doing? You guys are all getting out of here so I can show John. Right? Yeah, see, that's much better. This is the second time we tried showing John and this camera was better. I don't know. I like this. So I'm not sure about this transition though. Let's dissolve from, I kind of want to dissolve from Jeff to John. Let's try that, a minor dissolve. Very small. And Jeff's about to come in again. So, yeah, I like that. It's working out. I kind of want to go back and play what we've done. I wonder how long it would take to render it. Let's see how long it would take. Oh, not that long at all. Well, actually, kind of long. About a minute. All right, well, let's make this entertaining. You can watch me tuna for a minute. Oop. Unsuccessfully, apparently. Seriously. I've got 5 tunes done. And I don't know how many tunes I have total. We recorded the whole show, but apparently in the second set, some of the cameras conked out or something. I don't know, we'll see. I haven't looked at that footage yet. I've just been editing footage from the first set. We did 2 whole sets. And that stuff actually has been coming out pretty good. And I'm not sure what I'm going to do with this footage yet. I was thinking about maybe doing like a Louis C.K. thing, that comedian who released a concert of his online, and he was just like, pay whatever you want. Pay a dollar, pay $50, pay whatever you want. So it'd be nice if I could do that, but I don't know if I have a website that can support that at this time. This is taking a while. I'm just impatient. I'm going to be patient right now. Ready? This is me being patient. How's that? Yeah? Not bad? Okay. I don't know why I'm making this video or why anyone would watch it, but I don't know. Truth be told is I usually make videos about things that I find that I might, something that I might be interested in. I would be interested in seeing a video of a guy editing his band video. So, okay, it's going to automatically play it when it's done here, so we're almost there. 96, 97, 99. Okay. That worked. Did I switch to the close-up cam we talked about? That worked. All right, that all works. What do you think? Tell me. Okay. Let's keep going after some more tuna. Let's keep going. This tune gets more exciting, by the way. This is like the moody beginning. So what do we show next? We show Jeff. I think we should go back to that wide shot right there. Sometimes I get concerned about cutting from two of the same camera over and over, but I find that it's not really a big deal. It just ends up having like a ping pong kind of effect. So it's not really a problem. It's just me like overanalyzing. All right, not the most exciting shot in the world. What does this camera look like? More. Oh, actually, that might be kind of cool. What do you think? I like the movement of the symbol. I kind of like that my eyes are closed and looks like I'm concentrating. But you can't really see my hand. You can see my hand a little bit here. I don't know. Let's watch again. But if that symbol's going to... I don't like not seeing me hit the symbol. If we're going to show the symbol move, we should see the actual impact. Let's try that. Where does that happen? Right there. All right, let's dissolve into that, and hopefully by the time the dissolve is done, the symbol will have been hit. Let's give it a try there. Oh, that might work. And maybe back to the GoPro? Because I think my left hand's doing a little buzzy thing on the snare. When I say buzz, I mean taking the stick on the drum and like letting it bounce for like a zzz kind of effect, which I think is about to happen. Right? How does that... Let's see how that transition works from the side shot to the GoPro. Yeah, that works. Jeff is about to play the melody again, so let's cut to it. All right, you get out of here. I talk to the tracks as I edit them. I'm like, get out of here, Steve. Steve Sidecam, get out of here. Yeah, we get to scooch the sequence over. We're making progress. Very time-consuming, this process, but at the end of it, you know, it's worth it to have this cool footage of your band. Oops. All right. We were going to show Jeff, right? That's what we're going to do. Where's the Jeff cam? This is Jeff. Let's show Jeff. Nice. All right. There's a lot of... It's only guitar at that point. There's no face or anything, which I don't know, I usually like to start with something wide and then go to the close-up thing. I mean, I imagine for you professional editors out there, you might be going, well, duh, Steve. Of course, that's what you do. That's what all editors do. But I'm not a professional editor, and so you're going to have to bear with me. Oops, what is that? That's a frame of the wide shot. Let's zoom in. We don't want that. Oops, and by zoom in, I mean move. Okay, here we go. Yeah, see this guy. Scooch over. It's not your turn to be shown quite yet. It's not your turn to be shown either. Actually, what we're going to do, we're going to show the wide shot of Jeff. And then cut to the close-up. Do we want to dissolve from the GoPro to the wide shot of Jeff? Let's see. Should be earlier. The cut. I'm going to trim away a little bit of the GoPro cam so we can get to the Jeff shot quicker. Because I don't like that time. Yeah, see, that works. That was a happy accident, the placement of this the close-up track. Let's see that again. And then maybe back to the wide shot of Jeff. We haven't used the wide shot of the band for a while, but I kind of have a spot in mind for that that's coming up. So now we kind of ping pong from the wide to the close and then back to the wide again of Jeff. Let's see what that looks like. I really should stop singing. Okay, that fill I play right there towards the end. Let's go to the wide. that there. Da, da, da. Let's go to the wide. The overhead drum cam for that fill, and then I think I will go to the group. See right there. Da, 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 da. Although, we might go to the side camera on the second half of that fill. What does that look like? Because I hit this symbol. This symbol right here, I hit it, and it looks cooler from this angle because it's closer. Actually, I'm hitting this symbol and this symbol. So what we'll do is we'll show the first half of this drum fill from the overhead. And then the second half where I hit both those symbols, we'll use the side cam. See? Sometimes this stuff just, like, you get lucky, you know? We're going to dissolve out of the Jeff cam to the drum overhead. Yes. And then from here, we're going to go to the wide shot. But let's see what we have so far leading up to it. Because we, after that drum fill, we go into a completely new section. That's kind of a, I think the group shot of the whole band would work for that, for the this new section that we're about to go in. So let's do that. Here you are. Here's the wide shot. We'll scooch it on over. Yeah, that's what's next. All right, I'm going to zoom in. And we'll get some dissolve action. These cuts are short. Hopefully I won't think that they're going by too fast. I don't, it hasn't been that way. Like, watching this, it doesn't feel like it's cutting too fast in a way that conflicts with the pace of the song. That's the other thing, is I kind of like the pace of the song to match the pace of the editing. Although, you can actually use one to help the other. I find that if the song is kind of, if I want to give the illusion that, the music is quicker paced than it really is, then I'll cut cameras quicker than the pace of the song. All right, it's totally not playing because it's chugging. See, it's not even like, see, it's not playing where I'm putting the playhead. All right, let's do some more rendering. Just a small render, just so we can get through this. Come on, come on, Premiere. You can do it. Where's my workspace? Right here. How'd it go? It's not a riddle. Let's render this. All right, you get out of here, playhead. You scooch over workspace. How long will you take to render that? Now, see these colors here, like red and yellow and green? That just means that the videos are basically not ready to be played. If it's red, it means it's not quite ready to be played. If it's green, it means it'll play smooth. And yellow. Whoa, it's doing that thing again. Why are you doing that? Media pending? Why are you pending? You shouldn't be pending. You're right there. Don't pend. All right. Sorry, I'm just like clicking on things here. Let's scooch this over. Effect controls. Let me close this because I don't want this. There, I'll scooch this back over. Why is it doing that? Media pending. That's no good, folks. Let's render again. Weird. I don't think it's going to be like that when I export this, so I'm just going to leave it for now. I don't like that it's doing that. I'm not going to worry about it. All right, so we're on the wide shot of the band. So I'm going to scooch everything else over to give that some runway. Oh, weird. If I scrub through it, it doesn't do the media pending thing. But if I play it... Oh, now it doesn't either. All of a sudden, the media is no longer pending. Okay, so we get to see the drum fill the way it was intended to be played. Alright, I like that, but I think it cuts away too quick, actually. So I'm going to extend this out. Maybe, bam, the first snare hit. I don't know. What does that look like? Oh, you know what? It's time to stop dissolving, because now it's not, like, moody anymore. So... this part gets kind of groovy, so I say no more dissolves. It's time to do, like, normal cutting. Actually, we haven't saved for a minute. Let's save. Gonna take a second. Premiere's very finicky about saving. See you look. If you try to click on things while saving, and it's like, no, stop. And then it gets to the end and, like, takes its time. Yeah, what's up? Talking with my mouth full on YouTube. Alright. Alright, I'm gonna stop it right there. Yeah, see? Because the C on my left hand is up. I don't know, I just think that kind of works. That transition works better for me. Alright, I'm going to show the wide shot that whole time, because I like this section. Okay, that thing at the end, I kind of like what I'm doing there, so I'm going to try to show me doing it. Okay, that's not a good angle to show, let's do the overhead. Which means we have to cut the wide. It's warm in here. Need to turn the air conditioning back on. Standby. Okay. All right, where were we? We were showing the drums from the top down, right there. See, it's not. I don't know why that's red. I see 100%. Yeah, I don't know how that happened. Oh well. So I kind of like to cut to this shot right as I'm about to do that. Right? Boom. So. We'll scooch the wide shot over until that point and see how that works. Now it's all chuggy, which is a pain in the ass. How does this shot look? Actually, this might be better. Interesting. I don't know. I don't know. How long is this? I don't know how long we've been recording for. I'm not going to worry about it. Okay, I kind of like this angle better. Because I'm hitting these tom-toms here, like this tom-tom and this tom-tom, that's what those drums are called. I'm hitting them, and that always kind of looks cool when you're going down the tom-toms, like do-do-do-do, whatever. It looks better from the GoPro. Alright, so that's how long I want to show that. And actually what the band is doing here is we're playing these hits kind of together. You know, like we're playing these notes in unison, these long notes. And so whenever we do that, I kind of look down here and the audio, and I can see when that's happening, and I'll use that to help me line up when to cut to whatever it is I want to cut to. So the first thing I want to cut to is John, because he's due for some camera time, except as you can see, good Lord, what the hell is this cameraman doing? Look at this, I'm like scrubbing through. Oh my God, this is crazy. Look at this. Useless. Useless base footage right there. All right. Let's show John from here. Okay, that'll work. Stand by. Da, 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 da. Sorry. I have the volume down low so it doesn't bleed into the microphone when I'm talking. Otherwise it starts to echo back, but I do need to turn it up here a little bit. Sorry. Okay, that'll work. I don't even think he's playing a note. Actually, I'm doing it too early. Whoa, 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 what's going on here, Steve? Take it easy, take it easy. Alright, right about here is where we want to show John. And then we'll show Jeff for the next note. And we'll get these out of the way for now. I don't know how clear that is. Maybe we'll show Jeff here instead of John. I think we'll dissolve to Jeff, even though I said we were going to stop dissolving. I lied. Okay, I'm doing another drummy thing that I kind of want to show via the top down. That, right there when I'm on the tom-tom. Right there. I'm going to cut to the overhead drum cam at that point. Because we'll show some more drummy bits. Don't worry, John, the bass player, he gets a bass solo in this song. So he'll get plenty of camera time, don't worry. I always try to be, you know, equal about that in terms of not seeing too much of any one person. But if the song features, you know, someone, it features someone. What are you going to do? See, at the end of every drum fill, I'm like, so I'm hitting those cymbals from earlier, and that looked cool from the side before, right? But here we are with another, I don't know, I want to say useless shot. I don't want my feet hit. Oh, you kind of can see my face right there, a little happy accident. Yeah, that might work for the side cam that whole time. Looks like he's getting close on the hands, which might work because I'm about to do some little, I don't know, stuff that might look kind of neat from that angle. See right there? See? I don't know. Let's see what that looks like. Let's see how long we want to stay on that side drum cam now. That's what we're doing. Alright, let's go to this camera and I will know. Oh yes, that we gotta show. or like that because this thing that happens with the hi-hat there with the left foot. I'll show you exactly where. Right here, when I say hi-hat, I mean this thing right here, these two cymbals. Yes, see how it does that little open-closey thing, right? Yeah, right there. All right, what are we showing next? I always start to feel guilty if I show myself too much. I'm like, eh, okay, enough. Even though I'm an attention whore. What kind of person makes a video of them editing a video? Good Lord. Next thing you know, I'll make a video explaining how to do that. Crazy. Crazy town. Oh, you know what else is happening here? John is looking at me. John, the bass player, he's facing me. So that's good storytelling. I wonder if we could show him actually turn around. Man, that would be great. All right, let's find out when he does that. I'm going to turn off. I'm going to turn off the tracks above the John track and see if we can see. Right there, he turns. And he's kind of looking at me when he goes back. I wonder if we can. Kind of. Show that, you know. Oh, come on. This thing's mean. Okay, he turns around right there. So instead of showing the side angle of me, we'll show John turn around. And then we'll cut to the GoPro camera where you can see him looking at me. Okay, so let's get rid of these, because they're not being shown anymore. And at what point do we want to show him turning? Let's see. We're cutting now from the overhead drum cam to John turning. Right about there. So we'll play the overhead drum cam up until then. Actually, we were showing the side drum cam until then, but whatever, let's just go with it. That's not a lot. Alright, well, let's show John more then. Let's cut this overhead cam of me and we'll show more John. I don't know if we're going to get this storytelling here, if anyone's going to make that visual connection. Him turning. You can kind of see his guitar move too, so I don't know, it's all red right here. I need to like render this out. God damn it, Billy, we need to render these out. Sorry, that was my South Park. The grandpa in South Park? Was it Cartman's grandpa that's senile and he calls everyone like by the wrong names? God damn it, Bobby! Alright, let's render that out. See? That'll be done in like 2 seconds. For those of you still watching, let me give a personal thanks. All right, keep playing, please. Yes. Yes, that'll work. Daddy likes. Daddy likes. We're going to show John go back. Whoa, what's going on here? Some fancy hand close-up stuff? See, Jeff is about to take a guitar solo. So he's going to get a lot of camera time then. So this is a good time to show the kind of interaction between me and John. And I kind of like that. So, more eating. Sorry. Sorry, Internet. Right on that cymbal hit right there at the end, that's where we're going to cut out of this shot. right there. All right, so we're going to trim this over to that. Let's go to the John. Oh, what is the John close up doing right now? I'm almost afraid to ask. Yeah, see? It's nothing. It's nothing I can show. Actually, that's not bad right there. Is it? I hate when I want to cut to a camera and it's not like showing something good. So I guess, actually, I don't know, maybe the wide shot? Let's try the wide shot right here. Oh yeah, we get a little waitress walk by. Remember from the beginning? Good old waitress walk by. There it is. That'll work. Plus it'll kind of remind people of the club atmosphere that we're playing in. Another happy accident. All right, let's see how this works. I'm playing some stuff. The drums are playing some stuff there, so we might have to. Alright, we might have to cut to the drums here. Let's see. Right here, I'm about to play something here that I play way too much, and I play a lot in this video, so you should all prepare yourselves for that. It's a drum lick, I guess you could call it, called the blajda, because when you play it, that's what it sounds like. Blajda, 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 right? Drummers are crazy like that, but I play the blajda a lot in this tune, and I'm about to play it. Right there. Da blajda, that's what that sounds like. Ready? Dab, dab, dab. See? I don't know. I don't know if I like that angle right there. We're going to leave it, and then we're going to cut to, I don't know, maybe the GoPro footage again. Yeah, a lot of cool motion there, right? To the right, to the left. Let's keep that. Visually interesting, that's what that is. Let's see what John's doing now. Maybe if we're lucky, we can show the John close-up cam. Is he... What's going on here? All right. I think that's a... Whenever he nods his head like that, there's a big downbeat there. But I can't use... Can I use this footage right here? Let's see. Let's take a look. Oh no, I want to cut to the band at that point. All right, stand by. All right, that right there. Blah-da-doom. That is a big setup to the next section of the tune, which is definitely going to be a cut, probably to the wide shot. But for that little blah da doom, I want to use the overhead right there. I think. Stand by. Let's cut to the overhead in the middle of this cymbal thing and see how that works. Excuse me, Mr. Wide Shot. I feel like this is another one of those times where, like, professional editors are, like, going crazy. Like, why are you not zoomed in closer? You know, rightfully so. Because I probably should be. But blah to do. Oh, we need to get this out of here. The wide shot, we're not showing that. This needs to get scooched over. There we go. So what I'm trying to do is switch to the overhead drum cam when I play that drum fill that sets up the next section, right? It's a short fill, but I don't want to show it from the GoPro. So that's why we're changing to the overhead drum cam. Should I render that out really quick? I hate like rendering while I'm doing this. Let's see how long that's here. Not long at all. Okay, here we go. This next section is cool too, so. See? That's how drummers work. They sing the stuff they play. Okay, so let's just. Alright, nice. See? That's the next section. It's kind of a groovy section. So, thing is, like, I'm smiling during this part, and that doesn't happen a lot. See? Right there. So, I don't know, I kind of want to, whenever anyone in the band is, like, emoting, I kind of like to show that, you know? That's just good, good to see, you know? All right, that's good. That's good enough for that. What's John doing? I don't want to show him until then. What's Jeff doing? He's looking over at John. Okay, that's it. I see Jeff looking over at John. So we'll cut to Jeff looking at John, and then we'll show John to kind of tell that story, right? That's what's happening right now. Oh, nice. We got lucky with that one. And then we'll go to John, who, see what I'm saying about John not smiling? That's why whenever John smiles, it's like, oh God, we have to show it. Because Lord knows when that's going to happen again. I'm curious how long we've been doing this. I don't care, I'm having fun. Hopefully you are too. Maybe we'll go back to the wide shot. We did the wide shot, right? Then we showed me, then we showed Jeff. Maybe we'll go back to the wide shot after he makes that little gesture. Right there, we'll go back to the wide shot because he's about to take a solo. And so he's gonna get a lot of close-up time. So let's go back to the wide shot. So I'm gonna take it back a little bit. Okay, so right there is where the guitar solo starts. So it's going to be a lot of Jeff. He's about to play a really cool solo because Jeff is a fantastic guitar player. Okay, let's save. Now's a good time to save and have some tuna. It's bachelor night tonight here at the Steve Pad because the girlfriend's out of town. So back to eating tuna fish from a bowl. Okay, so guitar solo. Here we go. Whoa. What the heck was that he just played? All right, we're getting there. Want to cut to him right about here with his hand starting here moving up the neck. I like that. So let's start there. Do we want to use the wide shot? Let's start with the wide shot of Jeff before we go to the close-up. All right, we talked about that before. We talked about how that was kind of a duh. See, of course you want to show the wide thing. All right, here we go. There it is. Oh, cool. We get a little leg motion here. He's stomping on his pedals. I think what happened there is when he stomped on his pedals, he didn't have the right sound. That's why we're having a rough takeoff at the beginning of the solo. But don't worry, it's going to get awesome. Where do we bring in the close-up cam? Maybe here? Yeah, see, I like what he's playing here. I'm still having trouble, like, getting momentum from the beginning of this. See, there's space right there, and to kind of cover up the kind of rough start of the guitar solo, this is an example. This is one of those times, like I mentioned before, where it's like if we cut cameras, you know, kind of quickly in succession, it's kind of a band-aid, kind of a distraction, like, oh, nothing, you know, don't worry about the flub, just watch the cool camera cuts. Come on, play, please. Thanks. Is my refrigerator distracting? I just looked at this webcam here, and it kind of feels like my refrigerator is distracting. Is that better? Yes, it is. Ugh. No more distracting refrigerator. All right. Guitar solo. Oh, see, it's saving. This is my own fault. I could disable the autosave if I want to. I just don't. It's probably a good idea to have it on. All right, Premiere. See? It's like... Steve, I'll let you know when I'm done saving. All right? That's what Premiere says. Alright, when it starts zooming in there, that's when we're going to cut away. Right there. Question is, what do we cut to? Answer, back to the wide shot. So, let's move everything over. Sorry about the choppiness. Yeah, I don't know. When can we go back to the tight shot? Let's see. Oops. Sorry. When does the tight shot settle again? Right about there, when it kind of the camera moves down to his hands right there. That means we gotta stay on this wide shot for the whole length. And I kinda like that motion of him ducking up and down and then coming back up on the tight shot. That transition might work. All right, let's see. Kind of like that. That left-hand close-up thing right there. All right, let's do a quick scrub through of the John cam and see if he's like, you know, making any cool faces. Yeah, a little bit right there. Yep, making some faces. Good old musician faces. All All right, can't. We got to cut away there when his guitar goes up. Where is it? Sorry. Right there, in the middle of the lift. Let's cut. Let's cut to something, folks. The question is, what do we cut to? See the little razor right here? Cutting. All right, sorry. I don't know. I'm tired of the wide shot. I'm tired of going back and forth. Maybe the wide shots? I don't know. It kind of takes the intensity away of the guitar solo, though, if you like to go super wide. No, no, let's try it. Yeah, see? Dublows, more of that crap. Ugh. Am I smiling here? Oops, sorry, that's not what I meant to do. Do I smile? No, it's just a drum face. Do we want to show the bludge de bludge? That's the question. There's plenty more coming, don't worry. Let's show that from the top down. That drum fill. Doubles. Okay, everyone move over, please. Oops, sorry. See. Normally I would have my Premiere window much bigger, but I had to make it small to fit into this like desktop capture, you know, thing. Or else it was just chugging really bad. All right, we're showing the drum fill, right? That's what we're doing right now. Stand by. Doubles, bah. All right, that cymbal hit right there, this right here, I think that cymbal is visible from the wide Jeff camera, the wide guitar camera. So when I cut to that and you can still see the cymbal moving right here, I find that kind of... See? Same cymbal. I find that kind of shakes hands nicely, if you will. Yeah, see? Now Jeff's playing some shit. It's time to go back to the close-up Jeff cam. The question is, when? Answer, right about here. Yes, see, he's playing some stuff now. He just didn't have the right pedals on or something at the beginning of his solo. That's why it was kind of a bumpy start. But man, when he gets going, he gets going. See now this like transition to the zoom in on the guitar. I don't know. I don't want to show him during that. Maybe we'll get lucky and John's doing something. Yeah, he's giving Jeff. See those eyes? You know what that is? Pardon my profanity here, but that's the fuck yeah look. That's what that is. That's John going, yeah, Jeff, get some. Get some. See, man. See all the red here? That means it's going to be all chuggy when I play it back. Grrr. Oh, chugginess. I'm certainly not going to render this stuff before I even edit it. That would be crazy. All right, see what we've done? We've done all this right here. All right. I was going to go back and play through it up till now, but let's just keep going. See, that works well. The raise of the guitar during the cut. That's always the question. Like, when do you cut to what? And, you know, hopefully I've been sharing, like, my thought process on that. Come on. Chubba 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 ba. That's a candidate for the GoPro camera, that little drum fill. But chubba 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 cha. You'll see what I mean. Right there. Oh, no. Where is it? Right here, pa-cha-pa-cha-pa-cha-pa-cha. Stand by. Moving the slider over so we cut to the GoPro just when I do that and not any earlier. Because whenever someone else is soloing and I cut away from that person, I wanna minimize the amount of time that I'm not showing the soloist, you know. Yeah, right there. Chubba 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 ba, ba, and then back in for the backbeat. That's a good time to cut away from the drums. And back to... Oops. Yes, actually, yes. Everything can scooch over. Right? Let's go to the close-up of Jeff now, because we're spending a lot of time on the wide shot here, and I want to go back to the close-up, but once again, it's a close-up of his shirt. Yay! Alright, that'll work. Sorry about like this footage being like chuggy. Should I stop? I kind of feel like maybe I should stop. No, let's keep going. I can edit it later. I mean, stop making this, making a video. Right there is, you know, because in the solo, he'll play a phrase and then he'll take a beat. You know, there'll be small spaces in between the phrases, or, I mean, more importantly is, like, Jeff's a great player. He's the kind of player where, like, his musical phrases, they have clear beginnings, middle, and ends, right? It's like talking, right? When you listen to good musicians, you'll notice that when they play, it often sounds like someone actually singing or talking, right? And so there'll be, it's like a complete thought, you know, it's like he starts and he finishes it. And usually there's a little bit of space between ending one thought and starting another. And that's usually a good time to cut to a different camera. Right there, when he's doing, that's like a little space. So I can see his hand moving. So let's cut to the wide camera. Right, so this is the transition we're talking about right here. Yeah, see? Right there. He's starting another phrase right there. Okay, let's see what's next. All right. Another break, another ending of one phrase and starting of another. So let's go back. Let's go back to the close-up cam. This under the assumption that... Okay, here we go. Checking out the John cam, I see that I'm missing a lot of smiles, which is kind of a bummer. What's going on here, John? Are you smiling? Yes, you are. All right. Let's go back a little bit and see if we can show that smile of John's. maybe that much. I mean, like I said, I want to minimize the amount that I'm not showing the soloist. But I don't want the cut of John to be so short that it's like, you know, jarring. Like, what was that? Yes. That's awesome. Yeah, see that right there? We gotta cut to the wide guitar camera to so we can see that whole shot of him like bending down and making that face because he's really like getting into it. Right there, see? That's a good one. Let's do it a little earlier. Let's see how that looks. All right, back to the close-up cam. See, this is like guitar solo time. It's like far, close, far, close. There's actually a bass solo and a drum solo in here, so I don't know how long, I don't know how much of that we'll get to. I feel like now's a good time to save. So that'll take a moment. Yeah, I don't even know if I'm gonna use this video for anything. The video of me editing that I'm making. I mean, the music video I'll definitely use, but I don't know if I'll end up doing anything with. Making a video. We'll see. Okay, we were going back to the close-up cam, right? We were kind of ping-ponging. We got the smile. And then Jeff played that big cool note right there. We cut to the wide shot to get that. We stayed there, and then we went back to the tight cam. The question is, how long do we stay on that tight camera? Yeah, there's not much we can. Alright, I don't want to cut to the close-up camera till about there. So I'm going to scooch that over. That means we need to fill in this space right here. So we have the wide shot. Maybe I can use the whole. Actually, how is the wide shot of John, the bass player? Yeah, another good smile. Let's get that. Alright. Is there a drum thing happening at that? Yeah, see? I like that. It's all about showing the reactions because it gives people a sense of, like, you know, what the musicians, the experience that they're having on the stage, you know. Am I doing anything worth showing? Oh, I'm smiling too. Look at that. Can't really tell, though. Can you tell on the wide drum cam? No, maybe. Maybe we'll get lucky. No. All right, let's just go back to the wide cam of Jeff here. See, we're getting like intermittent bass player smiles. All right, that was the last thing we did was this, so let's play it. Yeah, play that drum fill again. I don't know if we want to show that because we're staying on this wide shot an awfully long time. Maybe we want to divide up like a band-wide shot. Because I need to fill in the space between this and this. Right? Like between this guy and this guy. That's what we're doing right now. And so I'm wondering if I can split the difference between the wide Yeah, actually, the wide shot might be the way to go because you can see John smiling still, and you can see me smiling, which we were trying to show before. And then I can just cut away from that back to the Jeff wide cam, which will then lead to the Jeff close cam, right? The question is, how long do we want to show the wide shot? Right there. Yeah, but see, we're not showing the blows, the blows. There's another one, right? That's like, we should count how many of those there are. The blows, the blows. Whoa, I kind of like that. Boom, that leg lift right there. Maybe we can get lucky. How's that transition? All right, see, Jeff is digging in right now. Digging in on Digging Out. That's the name of the tune, remember? Digging Out. Right, so what's happening? Let's take it back. Should we render? Should we render and see what it looks like, what we have so far, just for the last like little bit? Let's see how long that'll take. It'll take a minute. It'll take a minute. I really do have fun doing this stuff. I mean, it's challenging, it's gratifying, and the payoff is really good, you know? And I like making these videos and then sending them off to the guys in the band before we post them anywhere on the internet and get their feedback and stuff. That works. I think maybe we should stay on the wide shot until that bend of the knees, actually. Right here. I think we might want to stay on the wide shot that whole time. Because everyone's playing cool stuff there. Let's see how that works. Actually, maybe we want to go to the wide shot of Jeff instead of close up. All right, there's the downbeat right there. I can see me hitting the cymbal. So let's go to the Jeff wide shot instead of the Jeff close-up shot and see what that looks like. So let's scooch this stuff out of the way and see what that looks like, this transition. Yeah, that works. And then this is like the climax of the solo, kind of. So the cuts are going to start getting faster to kind of help convey that and, you know, help that cause visually, you know. Because things are about to chill out because John, the bass player, he takes a solo. That's good. Let's go back. Let's go back to the guitar wide shot right there. It's time to start like ping ponging back and forth like fairly quickly, I think. I need to do that earlier because I want to do that on the downbeat. Chubby, sorry. All right, we need to do this a little earlier so it lines up with the music. Yes, right there. See the transition with him like shaking the guitar? That totally works. All right, here's another downbeat. Let's go back to the close-up cam. Hopefully it's showing something cool. It is. All right, so he's, I think at this point, he's looking over to John to, as if to say, like, okay, my solo's done. You know, the musicians do that a lot. I mean, jazz musicians, they'll look at each other to kind of let the guys know, like, okay, you know, I'm done. It's just a visual cue. Yeah, see him look over right there? That's what I'm talking about. That's fairly common with jazz musicians, anyway. Actually, all musicians, I guess. I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. Alright. And after that comes the bass solo, but I think now's a good time to end this like making of thing I'm doing here. I almost want to play this all the way through, like what we have so far. Let me just render it out, and maybe I'll, I don't know how long that's going to take. Oh, not too long. So yeah, let's render out what we have so far. It's a couple minutes worth of stuff. But I think you can kind of get a sense of where I'm coming from, and, you know, make your own decisions as to whether or not you think that's working. I was pretty lucky to be in a position to where I could, you know, hire a crew to film my band and then you know, edit it. And which, when I initially spoke to these guys, like the guy that was in charge of the video crew, you know, I told him, I'm like, I just want the footage so I can edit it. And he was like, well, we usually don't do that. And he ended up being okay with it. So I was excited. I mean, it was exciting enough just to play live music, and it's exciting to have this kind of other creative output, you know, to use, you know, visual stylizing and kind of combine it with the music. But I like how the music dictates what happens visually. It's not only like a visual artistic thing. The music totally dictates what should be shown and when. And it's interesting to make that parallel, because while you're playing this music, it's the music that dictates what you play, like as musicians, you know, as jazz musicians. I remember a documentary of Branford Marsalis, that sax player, and the name of the documentary is The Music Tells You. And it's based on something that he says, where it's like, while you're playing, the music is telling you what to play next, you know? So that kind of goes for the editing thing too. You know, the music tells you what to show next, as long as there's a decent camera that's showing it. You know, we had a couple instances where it's like, oh, let's cut to the guitar camera or something. And it's like, oh, a close up of his shirt. And so we can't do that. So that doesn't work out. We're about halfway through this tune. And so this could go on much longer, but I think this is a good place to stop. So when this is done rendering, we'll play out what we have, and then that'll be it. So hopefully you found this to be entertaining and or useful. I've never done this before, by the way. I've never made a video of me, like, editing videos, or, I mean, I have other videos on YouTube of me playing drums and giving drum lessons and whatever. But never anything like this. And so, sorry if this sucks. I thought it was kind of weird having this webcam here, like, but I don't know. It's probably more interesting considering how long this is. Okay, here we go. In 5, 4, action. See, this is working for me. It's like showing the guys when they're playing their stuff. You know, when the dissolves are working too, the dissolve transitions. Kind of goes with the music, you know, which is kind of like moody. Yeah. lot of the wide shot. All right, here we go. Ooh, that's quick. I don't know if I like that. Oh, whatever. There's the smile we talked about. There's that buzz. Showing the smiling works. I think it's our solo. I feel like we've taken this journey together. Yeah, I like what he's playing here. Yeah, see, it feels like the band's cooking there, so that wide shot works. All right. On to the bass solo. There's a handful of things in there that I'd want to change. There's some quick cuts in there that I don't think work well for the pace of the music. But overall, I think it's a good first pass. So I'm going to end it there. Thanks for watching this. This is Steve Holmes. You're watching me work on Adobe Premiere Pro, actually 5.5, which is an old version. Also, I wanted to mention that the audio mix of this is totally temp. This is unmixed. This is just a quick mix that I threw together strictly for video editing purposes, okay? So, that's it. This is Steve Holmes signing off. See you next time.